didn't see it.
It's like they sell that here as well. They sell that here as well. That's the best shape cut bread I've seen. Oh, you're trying now. Show with the chips. Fluffy on the inside.
Can I have a dip of that?
Yep, there we go. Looks thick. Looks thick.
Oh,
wow. Rich and thick, isn't it? Mm. Wrong this side, yeah. Good colour. Good colour. And they're running as well. Oh wow. They're traditional then, definitely. Chipotle.
Not
too many chips. Just about the right size portion, actually. Bread's nice and soft.
It looks like
that homemade,
but it's like the same, isn't it?
I think it's like a
flat roll. It's
first time ever, finish the colour.
Finish what? Tell me.
I don't usually finish the colour, I just have a few dips.
Look at that, that's them. It's so good, isn't it?
I'm not better than that. For the fish.
You what?
And now for the fish.
Mm.
Mm. Good crisp batter. No skin on. Also, not that greasy.
What?
Not that greasy. Time to spit it out. Sometimes you get caked in grease, don't you?
Maybe that's all greasy sometimes.
There's no grease on the plate at all. Chips are all right for you?
Yeah.
Not too pale?
Could be a bit
bad. I think you don't like pale chips, do you? That's... trip now, aren't they? Nice. Residue on inside it. I was thinking that's slightly undercooked. Was that one? Was that one in Pontefract last week? It was same colour outside as it was inside.
And that's at the top of here. There's this building here, there's this Auckland's on it. And crossroad, I'm going to turn right here. It's down this hill here. It's a place called St. John's Church, down this road here. This is why we're not coming car. Up a thong lane. I'll film it when we get nearer to church. Still on under thong lane. This is the church. We should get in here. Walk around the path because it's at the back of the church near the handrail. It's this way. All these here, like sort of plaques of people.
Cremations, I think.
We are, this is a handrail. There we go. I can see it from here. There we have it, folks. Compo's grave. Bill Owen. MBE. Love and miss you, Tom, Mary, James, and William. These people have put wellies out there because he did wear them in lessons and wine. Can't see what that says. Thank you for your tributes to Bill Owen. This is the actual grave here. It's a bit muddy. William J. Owen Pro Botham, is it? Actor, playwright, 1914 to 1999. Educated by his wife Kathy. There's a picture there of Compo Clegg and Foggy. And right next to it, there is the grave of his fellow friend in Lessons in Wine, Peter Sallis, who played Norman Clegg in the series. Also voiced Wallace and Gromit. See, there's Wallace and Gromit artifacts around there.
It's like snow, don't you?
The shifting. get rid of somewhere. Yeah. Whippet and pickle. Bit Yorkshire, isn't it? It's got to be a pub or something. Yeah. Church, innit? We went in that years ago.
That's where I got that
thing
from.
So, I used to got recipe book, haven't you? So this pub up here, one corner, called Elephant and Castle, apparently they do a really great pub. That's another place to come. Yeah, it's called the same name, but it's not owned by the same people. Of China. So there's my family castle. It's a pub that serves food, isn't it? I'm just round this corner here. Where the Nora Batty's house. Still got this bridge. This car's gone past. And this other car's gone past. Yeah. I'm not not sure if, you know, further down the mouth is there, like, it's where,
what's it called?
Howard and...
Oh, yeah.
Other one left.
It looks like that, doesn't it?
It does, yeah.
Like next door, doesn't it?
And Clegg and Lee next door. This, I'm sure it were where... I thought Compo lived beneath her, didn't he? So, yeah.
Yeah.
Unless that were Compo's and that were Nora Batty's. I remember it had a blue door, so. Sewage pipe?
It's like a stopper, isn't it? A big stopper.
Private no through way. I bet I would be willing to say that that, where we're Cleggy lived, it looks so much like it, doesn't it? Anyway. Enough for
Elvis.
Yeah. Compo's choice, what's that? I can get as a camera lens on that.
Yeah.
Reflection on window. Now this will be Compo's house, won't it? Underneath Donna Batty's. It's got a blue plaque. That's a, it's got a blue plaque on it. As it's a yep, Compo's house. Nature's finest Liverpool Road. 1973 to 1999. Down here is where he used to keep his ferrets. What? Yeah. There's not much in these days, mate. Watch out, they bite, it says on it. Can't see it out. Medicine bottle up in there. Winkle stuck to your room. So this weren't at all, were it? This were like next door to Compo, really. It's closed anyway. There's a lot of people in there. That's cool, not about to stay. She's got a wash it out though. I don't know what they are. They're a bit small, they've shrunk a bit. Self-catering accommodation. Wow. Would you like to stay in Nora Batty's house for me? I can just hear her saying it now. Get off my step. Get away with you. There he is. God, these are steep. £5,000. They do look new though, then.
Yeah, they're
the
new.
That's cheap.
Yeah, you should ask because he's the one.
Yeah. 215,000. Old terrace downs. 680,000. God. That must be a flat. 119 grand. That's up for auctions, or it's any old place. Do the highest bidder, I'll give you five. £565,000 for a bungalow.
That's from the 60s, doesn't it, though?
Bill Lane as well. It's a good name. Probably bunks price of a bit, doesn't it?